इतना सफर, कुछ होने में और बहुत कुछ होने में इतना सा फर्क है, एक बार सोच के छोड़ देने में और लग के कर दिखाने में, मान लेने में कि जिंदगी ऐसे ही कटेगी और सुबह 4 बजे उठ के सोचने में कि अभी तो बस शुरुआत है, किसी मैगजीन को हाथ में लेने में और उसी मैगजीन के कवर पेज पे होने में इतना सा ही तो फर्क है, वीआईपी सीट में और उसकी पिछली सीट में इतना सा ही तो फर्क है, वो जिसका मैदान ही खुला आसमान है वही कल जमीन पर तो था, पूछोगे तो बताएगा वो पंछी, ये एक दायरे में सिमटने में और पूरी दुनिया को दायरा बनाने में बस इतना सा फर्क है, इतना कितना है, इतना है या इतना है, जो नापेगा वो जाने कि जहां धरती और आसमान मिलते हैं, नानकुर से दूर अगर मगर शायद से दूर, वहां भी दोनों में फर्क बस इतना सा है, धरती और सातवें आसमान में फर्क बस इतना सा है, ये एक अंतर प्रेरणा है, ये हमारी आपकी हम सब की अंतर प्रेरणा है, एक कदम, एक छलांग, एक बाजी, एक गहरी सांस और एक ललकार खुली हवाओं में कि हां मैं बना हूं उन फिजाओं के, कि हां मैं बना हूं उन ऊंचाइयों के लिए जो ऊंची तो बहुत है पर नामुमकिन भी नहीं, क्योंकि मुमकिन और नामुमकिन में बस इतना सा फर्क है, धूप छांव में फर्क बस इतना सा है, तो बस चलिए फ्रेंचाइज इंडिया के साथ ये फर्क मिटा देते हैं, फ्रेंचाइज इंडिया 20 years of ideas.
Thank you so much, Dheeraj, for a lovely motivational video which excites and motivates each of us at Ventures India to give something to our society. With this particular note, we welcome all of you to the 31st edition of Business Opportunity Over Chai webinar series, an initiative which showcases our brand, gives you the insight about and understanding about the brand, and then you select it. We welcome our panelist Gaurav sir, who will be joining us shortly, and Sonia ma'am, who's there on the screen, to take this webinar further. The brand of the day today is Bombay Sultani Biryani House, and we have Akshay Kumar, who's the founder of this great brand, with us today to speak about his brand. So with this introduction, I request Akshay to take us through the entire journey of Bombay Sultani Biryani House. Over to you, Akshay. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you, Archana. So Bombay Sultani Biryani House is something which started in 2015. And this came across as because, you know, we usually like our biryanis, and we like our biryanis little chatpata, masaledar and little moist. Most of the biryanis that we get today are, dry and, not very moist. And masala is always less. It's more of dry meat and rice. But our biryanis, are a little more masaledar, a little more desi, a little more chatpata. And that's how actually the idea of Bombay Sultani biryani came up, because that's the kind of biryani we get in Bombay, which is chatpatadar, masaledar, and a little moist. So that's Bombay Sultani. We have outlets across Mumbai, Nasik, Thane, and Goa. And looking forward to expanding all over the country and probably later all over the world. Thank you.
So, hi Akshay, this is Gaurav Maurya.
Sir, good afternoon.
So Akshay, we would request you to run through us the presentation so that our audience understand it better.
Definitely. So as I said, Bombay Sultani Biryani House was founded in 2015, and we currently have outlets across Mumbai, Thane, Nasik and Goa. And we have eight currently functional outlets as of today. Well, what makes us different than the other numerous biryani brands that we all see on Zomato, Swiggy and on the road is that our biryanis are more centric on a single portion basis. Our taste is, you know, more moist, masaledar, chatpatedar, and it's a meal in itself. Also, I have about 9 years of experience in this industry, from delivery kitchens to running restaurants of my own, which again, I'm still doing. So the entire experience of handling the manpower, arranging the manpower, fixing the menu, engineering the menu as per what you have to offer in terms of what the other person is offering, how to go one up, how to go two up from that. So as I said, the entire focus of our brand lies on two things. One is, of course, the taste, and second is the menu engineering. And I take pride in saying that our menu is engineered in such a way that, you know, at 150 to 160 rupees, a person can eat a hearty meal with a biryani, a starter, and a drink or a dessert. So that's where our core lies in. So we are selling biryanis single portion. So, you know, if there are three people and each one wants to order a different flavor, you know, you can order paneer, somebody can order chicken, somebody can order mutton. Otherwise, usually what happens is you have compulsory order a large portion of biryani which two people have to share. So that's where our engineering lies. Our starters, you know, we're selling it by the piece and not by the portion. So, you know, what happens is somebody wants to have something baked, somebody wants to have something barbecued, somebody wants to have something fried, or somebody wants to have something veg. So you're not, you know, compiled to order a particular portion and then compromise. Now you can order two pieces fried, two pieces baked, two pieces barbecued, and two pieces veg. So that is where our entire core lies on. And of course, along with that, we're giving a lot of management and manpower support to our franchise, because again, without the management manpower, which is the backbone of the business, this business doesn't really survive or sustain. Also, our biggest other pointer, which I've saved for the last, is that we do not charge any royalty from our franchise partners. Because charging royalty further on will only put another burden and reduce the profit margin of our franchise partners. And what happens then is most of the franchises collapse because franchisees don't pay royalty, the brand stops giving support, and that's where the doomsday starts. So again, our model is, as I said, it's a delivery model. And again, there are 100 delivery kitchens. Why should I start another delivery kitchen and be a part of the party? Well, most of the delivery kitchens, if you notice or if you see very closely, only have a shelf life between 6 to 8 months. Because, you know, just starting a dark end kitchen with no marketing, no visibility, you are not going to get orders. You may spend tons of money advertising on the apps, but again, your profit margin gets hit and ultimately you do not make money and you do not have funds to survive the next 6 months. So as I said, that's why delivery kitchen depends on a lot of other factors where, you know, you need to focus on apart from the food as well. First is the location. The location is most important, because if we are selecting a location and we have, say, a seaside next to it, then so much of that radius becomes zero for us. So we need to select the right location where we're in the heart or in the center of you know, a huge population, you know, because if there's a sea or there's a forest or there is barren land, so much kilometers of that radius gets wasted. Then as I said, the second part is menu engineering, because a customer who doesn't know a new brand would not order a biryani for 400 or would not order a starter for 280 rupees, always wondering how would the quality be. Should I take a risk or should I not take a risk? Or should I just order from my usual restaurant that I do? So ticket size, everything matters a lot. Visibility on the online ordering app matters a lot. You need to be visible at the right time, at the right place, with the right filters. Because if somebody is searching you and searching chicken tikka or a chicken biryani, he will have probably 100 options in his area. You will not be on the top 10. So filters, adding in the extra brand tiles or the extra visibility that you need to do on the app is where we again come into focus and help you with that. obviously the taste of the food, and more important is the consistency of the taste of the food. Firstly, you will get the taste right. Second time, yes. But most of the people, third or fourth time, the quality goes down. And again, that's where we are again in the picture here for. So we help you again now. Why Bombay Sultani? Well, as I said, those are the problems and here are the solutions that we have. We help you select the right location as per the right radius, as per the right demand in that area, as per stats in that area of what sells. For example, if we are opening a non-veg place in an area which is dominated by Jains or Gujaratis, we are going to have a tough time. So examples like this are one of the many other examples which matter while selecting the right location. Menu engineering, as I said, is we have single portions. So our biryanis start at 89 rupees, where a person doesn't mind experimenting at 89 rupees, you know, because he has less to lose. If the same thing was 289, and you know, he would probably not try. But at 89, he will come to your page, he will order the menu at your cart, he will pay it. But if it the same was a higher price, he would probably come in and have a second thought whether, you know, should I really waste that kind of money or experiment that kind of money on a new brand, or should I just order safely from where I used to order? So again, the third point, we give you complete manpower support for the smallest, biggest issues, complete handholding, because, you know, as I said, that this business is more of the experienced, you learn this business more on experience rather than learning it off a textbook. So that's where, again, we come into play, complete handholding, complete support throughout the term. So, you know, there are expenses which just come by and then we're left at loggerheads whether, you know, we never accounted for this. So these kind of experiences that we have will help you save the money and save your capital. And so our document, and third is our documents, our dockets are very friendly. It's all in the form of a checklist. So as you sign up, you're given a 3-page docket where you have to, you know, get small things like you have to get your bank account done, you have to get your PAN card done, register your company. So you never miss anything or nothing is delayed. You know, a docket is given to you where you just need to tick mark 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 done and your outlet is ready. It's as simple as that. The last and the most important is our process is completely transparent. It's not that you have to procure everything to us or give us the money. We wouldn't, as I said in my earlier point, we would be giving you a docket and document of the equipments that you require with options of vendors in case somebody has a contact and is able to procure it at a cheaper rate, that is their saving. So, you know, I've left the process completely transparent where whatever money you're spending is you are spending in and not handing it over to us in any case. So that is why you should choose Bombay Sultani. And again, the last and most important point again is we do not charge any royalty from our franchise partners. So whatever you make and whatever you earn is completely yours. Now coming on the impact of COVID-19 or coronavirus, a lot of people are in two minds whether this is the right time to invest in a business. Okay, if this is the right time to invest in a food business, well, the answer is yes, this is the right time. And food business is something, you know, is the home delivery business is here to stay. It's going to jump and jump because a lot of people would refrain from going out to crowded places or to places with, you know, where there are tables next to each other. You'd rather call in friends or family and, you know, have a small party at home and order food from outside. I know a lot of people have become master chefs during this lockdown phase. But again, cleaning, chopping, cutting is a tedious task. Our setup cost is low compared to other outlets. Our ROI, that's a return on investment, is comfortably achieved in 18 months. You know, that is something why, again, the home delivery business is recommended. Also, you know, in a market like this or in a scenario like this, this becomes a strong second income or a dual income where, you know, people in existing jobs who always would have the insecurity or the fear of being terminated or having a reduced or taking a pay cut, you know, this is always a good second backup option that you're creating. Always know that this is not an expense. You know, a lot of people would have the thoughts that, you know, ye time pe business pe paisa nahi dalna chahiye. But, you know, I would say this is an investment. Please look at it from a long-term perspective. This will generate you money. This will always give you a second, you know, option. And in places like metros in like Bombay, Delhi, Bangalore, where it's so tough to survive, you know, a second income or a dual income is necessary in order to sustain and survive and lead a good lifestyle. Also, a lot of people who may have lost jobs, this is something wherein, you know, you can start. It doesn't require much of rocket science. You don't need to know cooking. You don't need to know how to manage a restaurant. All you need to know is management in general, which I'm sure your existing job would also have demanded. You just need to be a good manager. And that's what I am. And that's what a lot of restaurateurs are. So, as I said, again, Zomato, Swiggy are there. They're here to stay. There is Amazon, which is coming in. There is Jio, which is coming in, the food delivery business as well. So it's going to be a big market. If people like players like Amazon and Jio are coming in, then we can only imagine how much potential there is in this kind of business. So that's with regards to the COVID-19 impact. It's completely safe to start a home delivery kitchen, because if you notice, home deliveries were allowed throughout the lockdown period as essential service. So, बोलते हैं ना तीन चीजें हमेशा चलती है, रोटी, कपड़ा, मकान. So, well, this is regards to food, people would always eat. And value for money food, people would eat all the more. So, we have two models that we are offering. First is a kitchen takeaway model where there is no seating that is required. It is only a small 200 to 400 square feet space, but on a very, very located on a very, very busy junction or a railway station or a bus station road or a market road where there's a lot of footfall, you know, of people, because our menu is such that it's designed to cater to the masses where your footfalls are higher. So, example, a person has come to a market to shop. All they would need is, you know, we have these starters called keema pav. So keema pav is available as low as 29 rupees. It's chicken keema in a nice butter pav and served at 29 rupees. Why would somebody eat a vada pav, which is fried, at 10 rupees or 15 rupees when you can get the option of having a keema pav? So that's why location is important. Or, you know, like a station road, like in Bombay, a lot of people use the local trains. So station roads are always very busy, and a lot of people on the way home wouldn't mind taking a biryani or two at 89 or 169, two biryanis home for their family and eat along their food. You know, that is why the location matters a lot. The setup cost comes to between 12 to 15 lakhs. The breakup is 5 lakhs is our franchisee fee. Kitchen equipment is about 3 lakhs. Again, we have options of procuring a used kitchen equipment or take over an existing outlet, which is probably shutting down. A little bit of furniture fixture, about 2 lakhs. Signage branding, which is again the definition, which is the inviting point, has to be spectacular. We keep about 1 lakh for that. Electronic white goods like your computer and your TVs with the displays, about 1.5 lakh. Licensing, brokerage, other miscellaneous expenses at about 1 lakh. So between 12 to 15, comfortably you can set up your own kitchen on a busy junction and expect it to run from day one, rather than, you know, having to keep working capital and all. Because your location is good, you won't need to keep operating expenses high. And on the other part, we give you complete management manpower support throughout the term. There's a free replacement in case any chef or any of your outlet staff leaves and goes. We give you completely free replacement. I'm repeating that. And along with the training, it's not that the training is not done. We send you trained staff in case anyone leaves due to whatever reason. We offer a completely free replacement within 24 to 48 hours. Because that is the core, that is the strength of your business. As I said, no royalty, no hidden charges, no extra charges, staff training is included. So it's a very simple, clear-cut, basic franchised model. The second model, this is, we have introduced, keeping in mind the COVID scenario, where a lot of our investors have, you know, expressed their inability to invest that kind of money and opted for a simpler model. So we have called it a satellite model, because it's as simple as you can open it anywhere. Ready-made food would come in to you. All you have to do is heat it, plate it, and serve it. As simple as that. food will come daily from our central kitchen, so there is no thing of quality problem, consistency problem, or the taste problem. Nothing of that sort would happen. All you need to do is heat up the food and serve it. The shelf life of this kind of food is 5 days in the fridge. Just like if we also make food at home and we make extra, we always do save it in the fridge for about a day or two. And the taste of the food is always better the second or the third day. So this model is simple. It is 8 lakhs of investment with 6 lakh rupees as franchisee fee, equipment and basic equipment required like a fridge, freezer, which comes to about 1.5 lakhs, another 50,000 for your software licenses, brokerage or other miscellaneous expenses. And as I said, you just require one or two people at the outlet, and all they have to do is warm the food and heat it, and it's done. Systems of inventory is all provided by the brand, and you can start this outlet within a week. Within a week, you can be listed on online platforms. You can, it's just a plug and play model. You decide you want to do it, and we can begin as soon, because you don't need much training or much anything for this sort. So this is also called as a dark kitchen model, where your operational costs are lower, your rent is lower, and your ROI is achievable in less than 18 months. Usually we take it as 18, but in this model it's less than 18 months because your expenses incurred are way lower. So again, coming to the main point is we prefer to, we have been in many years. So again, you have to partner with us because all the experience, all the wisdom, all the guidance, all the handholding is provided by us, where, the smallest of and the biggest of mistakes, which probably a new person in this business would make, is avoided. And that what happens is that is something which can make or break your business, because a lot of people end up spending where they have to spend 100 to end up spending 500 and are not left with working capital to survive and sustain your business. So what happens is you invest that money, but then later on you decide, I don't have any money and I don't think it's worth putting in money from my house to let this business. So I shut it down. So you've lost in capital, you've lost an opportunity, plus demotivation. So again, this is something which is where we come in to play and make sure that all that costs are, saved and spent smartly. So that is the investor we're looking at. Somebody who's doing a corporate job, a satellite model is perfect. Somebody who's, at home and is a freelancer, you can operate the regular model. You don't have to sit over there at the outlet. No, our systems are not as such that you have to sit at the outlet. No, all you have to do is monitor for two things, monitor for management and monitor for hygiene. These are two things which are very crucial in the food business. You need to, again, as I said, our reports, our systems, softwares are very well in place. Everything is at a touch of a button from any location, be it you're in Bombay or in San Francisco. You can view your sale, you can view your cameras, you can view your inventory, you can view your orders, you can view feedback, everything from your smartphone. So this is our model, simple, to the point, and extremely spot on.
Thank you, Akshay. Lovely presentation. We also get charged listening to you because you have a high energy guy, and always on move. And I remember when lockdown started, I had a call with you and you were still very busy. And we would like to start with hearing your story, that how you as a nimble entrepreneur, can quickly change around the model. It will be good that if you share with our audience that what you did when every lockdown happened, and how you change your menu and what you started doing. And so share with everybody, so people would like to understand that how quick you react on adversity.
So as the lockdown started, we figured out that there is a big gap in the market. And that big gap is that one, people would cook at home, but they would still want to eat outside food, because one has been doing that for the last so many years. So we started our DIY kits, that's do-it-yourself kits, where you can call for raw food from outside and comfortably and most satisfactorily heat it, warm it at home in your own presence and still enjoy the outside taste. So that is something we started, those DIY kits. Again, I think, Ms. Maria, you were the motivation to get me on that when we discussed ideas. So that was something which really changed this thing. Then also, we also started looking at a lot of outlets which were shutting down. I remember Mr. Maria had told me that, you know, look out for outlets which are shutting down and pick them up at a bargain. So your capex cost is saved by almost 50%. So we've closed one franchisee, and that outlet should be live in the next couple of days. So, you know, we picked up a existing outlet, which that guy had spent about, say, 6 lakhs or 7 lakhs. We got it at 2 lakhs. So the franchisee saved money, outlet got live, and, you know, that's how things happen. We're also in talks with a couple of other people and looking at possible these bargains. So these are two things that we did, the DIY menu and the looking for opportunity in, you know, diversity, as I say.
Yeah, absolutely. And I think you obviously are hardworking and a very progressive entrepreneur, and people like you who are progressive, in, especially in these times, always find opportunities. And I clearly see that this time is all about a lot of consolidation. Good operators, aggressive operators would always get an opportunity to improve their market share. They would consolidate a lot of independent players which would not be able to survive. And I think a lot of things are going to happen. Brands which have chain, like you are a chain, would be able to attract better talent, because a lot of talent would get would not like to join now independent stores. Because if you were running an independent dark kitchen, nobody would like to work with you because they will feel insecurity. But when they're working in a brand chain, they would like to be part of it. So let's start working on giving our audience a little bit understanding on this dark kitchen space. While you've given very clearly, I like your algorithm situation, and I everybody is understanding the algorithm, even this platforms run. So platforms exactly know where is what demand coming from. So if you are in a particular neighborhood, it's like in Andheri, one corner, they would understand that how many people order South Indian, how many people biryani, how many people this. So when you design the kitchens, you work in coordination with these platforms. You understand what the demand is being created, what kind of size or volume. And why I ask this question, because it's very important in franchising. One of the big pillars is predictability. How do you able to bring predictability to business model? Because all the other pillars of franchising you qualify to, you know, it's a very affordable franchise. It's a scalable business. It is also sustainable business, because you don't have a big, especially on dark kitchen, because you don't have a big rental, and now you will get a cheaper rental. So everything is there. But I want to like to stick to that. How deep you go into creating that predictability, and what trends you've seen in dark kitchen, that what first quarter revenues can come, second quarter revenues can come, third quarter can come, and go even also deeper in terms of your weekday business, weekend business, trading hours, is lunch heavy, this heavy, and how can you improve trading hours, which means that your kitchen is available, it's an asset. You need to sweat out the asset, which means that if it is, it can work for 12 hours. This is what the biggest problem in restaurant business is, because restaurants only sell for 6 or 7 trading hours, and they are open for all day. Only 3 hours of lunch and 3-4 hours of dinner, and that's about it. And they pay rent for 24 hours. So how they can create more trading hours? So a little bit on that. So trading hours, how do you bring predictability, and how do you really maximize your business model? So over to you, Akshay.
Thank you. I'll answer the first question is predictability. Now, when we come to predictability, again, the top 5 cuisines in India across surveys are pizza, burger, Chinese, biryani, North Indian. So we are comfortably placed in the most safest, most ordered food items across the country. So that is where predictability comes in, because again, biryani is safe. You know that it's among the first or the second most ordered thing in the menu of people.
Just for audience, it is the first most favorite food for Indians is biryani. And only one city, which is Delhi, actually has chosen samosa as a favorite product for them. But otherwise, almost all cities in India, when the Times did a survey, biryani came as a topmost. Yeah. Over to you.
Yeah. So as again, biryani comes in, so that answers the question of predictability. But however, it cannot be as large a focus that, you know, it is in the top 5, so it will sell anywhere and everywhere. No, that's not the only thing. So as you know, you have achieved the first milestone about being in the top 5 cuisines of the country. The second comes in the demand of veg versus non-veg, or the demand is that a lot of people would want something more than beyond biryani. So that's where it's also linked to your next question, is how the scalability comes in of in cashing in 24 hours in a day. So what we do is we have created sub-brands which go by the name of, you know, there's a brand called Zabardast Paratha Company, which we have started, which is again from the same kitchen listed online. So what happens is a person who wants to order paratha would do so more from a dedicated paratha joint rather than ordering from a biryani joint. So we have left focus of each brand to itself. So we have Zabardast Paratha Company, we have Awesome Burger Company, which is a burger dedicated brand, we have Bombay Chinese Company, which is a dedicated Chinese brand, we have Frontier Kebabs, which is a dedicated kebab brand. So there are more chances that people would like to order things from a specialized store rather than ordering from a generic store, unless you have a really big name or something. So people generally go in for the exact thing. So these are those small online menus that we only do. So what happens is we are also giving more options to the customer, but we are also encashing our own competition. And then we have all these snacky brands, which is Vegas Milkshake Factory and the Pav Bhaji Factory, which are our snacky brands. So, you know, between 4 to 7, as you said, is a dull hour for restaurants. So Pav Bhaji Factory and Vegas Milkshake Factory are our snacky brands, which take care of the business between 4 o'clock and 7 o'clock, and also sometimes in the morning. So that's where we encash our opportunities. That's where we milk the cow even more by having these other sub brands along with the mother brand. That's Bombay Sultani.
Sure. So we would like to go deeper into this. We have got very good understanding, and this is what is happening to the world. We call host kitchen. One kitchen is hosting a lot of other brands also, while it has to have a fitment of what we call their forfeits, which should be always there: strategic, financial, operational, and marketing. Operationally also, I always advise we should not create brands which cannot fit into the same skill set of people to do it. So say for Chinese, you need a wok and you need to always have that entire thing. For North Indian, you need to have a tandoor for something else. So unless some guy who works on a tandoor doesn't sometimes know how to work on a wok. So it should not go more on manpower, but anything which is strategically fitting that, like a paratha fits in, your milkshake fits in, this is a beverage brand, and even Pav Bhaji fits in. So all these brands makes a sense. So just for an audience, that when you buy a Bombay Sultani franchise, you also get a couple of more brands also integrated with that. And they, all the brands are independently put on the platform. So Swiggy would actually identify them as independent kitchens. And a same person would not be able to know when he's using a Swiggy or a Zomato. He will place an order for biryani on Bombay Sultani, but he will order, say, a paratha company, something else, and so on and so forth. So you will be able to take your trading hours more. In the morning, people might order parathas, and in the afternoons, you might get Chinese orders. By evening, it becomes more biryani because people don't mind having any more indulgence at home. And in the day, you can have these smaller shake, milkshake brands, or a Pav Bhaji in the evening, or things like that. So it becomes, your trading hour becomes consistent. Now, my question is that there are two questions which I would have, and then I will pass it on to Soumya. One, you are not charging royalties, while it pleases a lot of people, and I'm now more as a critic talking. You're not charging a royalty, which I know why you've done that, because you want to give the benefit to the investors. But it also creates sometimes in a doubt of investor, because you're not charging anything. After once I have taken a franchise, while you help me set it up, then how do I make sure that I will continue to get support from you? Because every time people think when you don't charge a franchise, you will say that because you're not getting anything from me, how would you continue to support me? And my support would run over the next 5 years. I need your support for 5 years. So what would be your answer? That's a question number one. The second question is, are you also open for developing with the larger partners? There are very good partners today who probably can work with you to develop regions. Somebody can develop Bangalore, somebody can develop Chennai, somebody can develop Calcutta. Are you also open for looking at an area developer or a master franchise or something like that? So these two questions for you.
So I'll answer your first question about what is the motivation for somebody who's taking my franchisee when he knows that there is no royalty, and he's always in the fear that he's not you know, what if he puts his hands up after the fourth day or the fourth month, for example? So, well, first things first, again, you know, whenever we do something, there's always a catch 22 that always comes in. But I'll answer the question in a way that so royalty is not something we charge. We give our base gravy to all our outlets. That's where we have a slight margin, and we're very open and very transparent about it. So our base gravy comes in here. What happens is the franchise also is assured that the taste he's had the first time during the tasting and he has now is the same. Second, his dependence on manpower reduces. So he doesn't need a chef worth 20,000 rupees who has to make the base gravy and is always in the headache. Aaj taste same hoga, nahi hoga, nahi, us time taste better tha. All that problems are eradicated. And obviously, you know, whenever somebody needs a little peace of mind, it always comes at a slight premium. So that's why we have abolished royalty. And instead, we have made a win-win situation of providing the base gravy to all our franchise, be it in Bombay or outside. And these have shelf lives. And what happens with this is your taste is consistent. So a person who orders a biryani in Nasik or orders a biryani in Bombay or in Goa would have the same taste of the biryani, because apart from the ingredients and the masala, one more critical factor is very important, and that is the water used. Because in some places, the water is high salt, somewhere low salt, somewhere higher grain, hard water, soft water. So there is always a thing of salt and water in the food which actually makes or breaks it. So if it's made in our central kitchen and given out, your headache of existing and dependence on manpower reduces. Plus, you save on money. Plus, your taste is consistent. And coming to your point of, you know, the support that we offer, well, as I said, our systems are so much so in place that you won't need to come to us, because our documents and dockets are so practical, so apt that you will enjoy working on it and you would not need our support, because it's been explained to the most basic point. And obviously, we are always there on a phone call. It never hurts to answer a phone call. If there are bigger issues, we always attend it, because we value partnerships. And again, I always tell my franchise partners that if I'm able to help you and satisfy you so much so, why would I have to go and sell my franchises somewhere else when I'm very confident you would take one more franchise? So I work on a view that my existing franchise would open one more and one more, rather than me going to various people and selling franchisees. So that is more of a customer satisfaction point for me, as well as a more of a motivation for me to serve them better.
Sure. And master franchise and area franchise?
Yeah, we are definitely open for master franchises or regional franchises in India and outside, as I said. So the main thing is that it's about the consistency and the taste of the food, and the partner has to have that same passion in the food business, which is most important, more probably than the money also. Because the food business is something which is exciting, but a lot of people lose motivation, lose interest, you know, in 3 months, 4 months. But be passionate, and it's something that comes from within. So we're looking at these passionate master franchise partners as well across the country to help us grow.
Absolutely. And I think for all the audience, I think this can be a good opportunity if you want to develop the region, because some people have ability to bring further franchisees and so on and so forth. So you should really talk to us if you're looking for becoming a larger partner area franchise. We will obviously take you to Akshay and organize your call or a discussion. This is a great time for two aspects. One, obviously the rentals are softened, and every webinar we say this is a good time for you to take a piece on that. Second, there's a lot of assets that are available, especially in the food business. The initial capex was a very big problem. The equipment was very expensive. And now, because a lot of equipment is available, and actually, if you can set up from a resale of equipment. In America, most of the restaurants, you don't know if it works still on the resale of equipment. Equipments are steel tables. They don't go anywhere. So I am encouraging people to really use a lot of equipment and other things that are available, which would bring your capex significantly down. You can acquire, like Akshay has already acquired a kitchen, which was already running, independent kitchen. And a lot of independent kitchen people would not be able to run and operate. And there is a good acquisition opportunity available in the market. And if you go, you can probably get, like, he got about 6 lakh rupees invested only in 2 lakh rupees. Now, just a 2 lakh rupees, you are in the business, and how much time it will take for you to take it out, your capital. So it's a great time from what I call this micro acquisitions. And every city has so many assets available, and both Akshay can help and Franchise India can also help in terms of getting you those locations and so forth. Now, I'd like to invite Sonia, Fania, for your remarks and questions. A lot of questions are pouring in the group also.
Thank you so much, Akshay, for putting this presentation together. And I saw a lot of questions, and I was taking a note while you were presenting it. And I'll start with giving maybe a bit of my perspective before we pick up these questions. And I remember when we started off the webinar, we talked about the last call we had. And that was the time we were also speaking to many other food operators. And most of these food operators were not working that point in time. Many of them were running their restaurants, which required sit down, and they were not working. And you were the only one, perhaps, we spoke who was doing well even at that time. You changed your menu. So, you know, which reflects a lot of agility and, resilience in the model, perhaps, that you've built. And if you see the last 10 odd years, there has been a big shift in how the restaurants or the entire food space has been working. We are shifting to a more organized sector. And that becomes even more important now, because I feel these times there are two important elements which have become very important as far as food is also concerned. One is your customer retention, you know, how many people are coming, how many of these consumers are consumers who perhaps come to you very often. And second is the depth of offering. One cannot be a me-too brand or a product like any other brand, where you need to have a destination product where people come from. So these two things for me, which is, one is customer retention, and the ability of the brand to offer in-depth offering is something which are table stakes. And also, you know, since brands today, if you see, only the brands which have been trusted by the people are doing well. They're the ones where most of the orders perhaps came in. And in particular, you know, whereas these dark kitchens are concerned, the biggest crisis is where a lot of these players are unorganized today. There's also bigger concern of these players to convince the customer about the safety, so to say, and they're not even regulated. And while the shift towards organized was always growing, but the current impact will be much higher on the growth of the organized sector. As far as biryani is concerned, I was also reading some stats which also have come out from companies like Swiggy. They work on big logarithms, like you mentioned, and while it does not serve Pan India, and there are other players like Zomato who are also doing that. The stats which I read were very interesting. Almost 75 biryanis were being ordered on the Swiggy platform for the year 2019, which was last year, which makes about 1.6 biryanis per second that were ordered from the platform of Swiggy. And they also mentioned, this particular category was also giving a run to other companies which are offering products like pizzas and burgers, which is a big competition. So we all understand this category is growing. We have good investor interest, which has come in. A lot of players have also raised money. But when it comes to the franchisee, we feel there are five elements, and you've talked about these elements elaborately. I'll pick some of these. So which is how sustainable the system are, one, how much the system is in demand. Third is the value of the investment for an investor, the money he's putting in. Fourth is the support which comes from the brand. And fifth is how stable it has been. So these are five parameters which I feel, you know, make a big base for anybody, perhaps make a choice of investing in the business. And also, like you mentioned, this is a business, and why people are more interested and why it is sometimes very easy to operate and also scalable are two reasons, because it is a volume-based business, and also it is easy to standardize. And typically, if you see the Indian menus, they're very difficult to standardize, and they cannot go beyond certain locations because of the diversity of the Indian cuisine. But in case of biryani, one can standardize the specimen of rice or the meat or some spices, and you can customize that. You said you can do that for people who are just vegetarian or Jain food. So it makes it an interesting proposition from the standardization point of view, and also scalability, where a little bit of training and you make the business model idiot-proof. I'll take one question, actually, which has come, and I'll take one which is on the unit efficiencies. In the presentation, and I saw some of the people also asking in the chat box, I saw the fees. There are two components. One is the margin on the food, which you said is 50%. We need to understand how that calculation comes in. And if you also can give us understanding of how much would be the occupancy cost, what is the food cost? And second is on the franchise fees, where the smaller model has 6 lakhs and the satellite model has 6 lakhs and the other model has 5 lakhs franchise fees. Why that differentiation? And and the margin on food, which is 50%, which I feel is a little high. So can that explain it to our audience, please?
Thank you, sorry, ma'am. Coming to the point of the margins on food, so again, if you're making food in your own kitchen on a takeaway model, where you're cooking everything from scratch using our gravies, your food cost is 35%. That is when you're making on the higher side. So this is your food cost, including gas and everything. The second is, if you're procuring food from us, your food cost is 50%. Now, there's always a difference between making something in-house and outsourcing it, because there are other costs involved, like manpower and rental. It is either you pay for it or I pay for it. Somebody has to pay for it. So that is the only difference between the satellite model and the takeaway model. Also, there's an extra a franchisee fee of 1 lakh rupees between the kitchen model and the satellite model. Reason being is because out of this 1 lakh franchisee fee, 50,000 is a token, which is a deposit, which is refundable. Because what happens is, in case we are not getting payments from you, this is just a deposit for that purpose and nothing else. And the reason it is higher, because what happens in delivery kitchen is there are a lot of more logistics involved from our end to you, where the headache is more on us and less on you. Because we have to ensure timely supply to you, make sure your inventory is always stocked, make sure your wastage is as good as zero, because you really don't want to order a lot of things and then be stuck with ready-made food and it doesn't go. So all that thing is on us, where, you know, for the first few weeks, whatever wastage happens, we take it back from you and we don't bill you for it. So that is the kind of support, and that is where the extra premium comes into play.
Great. I will have another question again on the sales and efficiencies, and keeping these 2 or 3 months aside, what has been the average sales based on the 8 outlets that you currently run, and what kind of absolute margins can one outlet make, you know, an average running outlet, and what has been your peak sales in the best outlets and the average sales maybe in the outlets which are not doing that well?
So on an average, our sales across the month are between 4 lakhs to 5 lakh of rupees. The highest sale is done by our Andheri outlet, which is again owned by us, and it is about 5 years old. That does a sale between 10 to 12 lakhs a month. The lowest sale currently is happening in Nasik. The only reason, because they're facing a little issues with the mindset of people who are ordering from outside. Otherwise, our sales, our Thane outlet is doing phenomenally well. In fact, better than it was earlier, because we are encashing on the thought that a lot of restaurants have shut and we are open and the encashment is happening. The same goes with our Santa Cruz outlet, which is again my outlet. The same goes with our Bandra outlet, which is again a franchise. It is again ready-made food, heat, serve, supply, as simple as that. So our Goa outlet is again doing phenomenally well, because Goa things have opened up. You know, there was never really a lockdown as such, because Goa always reported less cases. Coming to the actual margin that is left, you know, to be very, very honest and upfront and realistic, the margin on a takeaway kitchen is between 20% to 25% in hand, which is realistically left after giving out all expenses. The margin on a satellite kitchen is between 10 to 15%. And that is also, again, after taking in all expenses, all traveling, transportation costs. These are the realistic margins. It can't go below this. It can only go above this. But this is, again, the realistic margin. I don't want to promise 30%, 40% margins, because those would never happen. And I don't want to give a false, you know, or a misleading figure to anyone. So these are the realistic margins in our business, where what is left in your hand after removing everything. And by everything, I meaning everything, your packaging cost, your gas cost, travel cost, mobile cost, internet, everything.
Great. So you talked about location. So I'll take two aspects. One is technology, one is location. So if you look at the current business model, businesses are doubling down on the online channel. And there's a stronger demand which is being seen. And that has been the trend for at least the last year and more in the last few months that we have seen that growth coming in. And a lot of players, especially in the biryani segment and overall, you know, they've seen the contribution of online contributing close to about 75%, which includes both delivery as well as takeaway. How do you see yourself prepared for the shift? And are you integrated with all these platform companies? One. Second, since a lot of business would be delivery and takeaway, what kind of locations you are suggesting your franchisees to look at? And typically, what rentals should these locations come at?
So answering the last question first, what the rental should come at. Well, I am always of a believer that anything good always comes at a price. You know, it's not something that we want the best location at the cheapest price. That won't happen. If the location is good, it demands that price. I would say pay it, you know, because that is eventually going to get you the walk-ins and the footfalls and the business. Like, I'll give you an example of our Andheri outlet, which is again started by me 5 years ago. It is at the right junction of a very, very prominent market signal. So every 10 minutes, there are about 50 cars which line up over there. Each of them is looking at the board as the signage, giving a call, send me 3 biryanis, send me 4 biryanis. That space is not more than 120 square feet, but I'm paying a rent of 60,000 rupees. But then paying 60,000, I'm getting a business of also 10 to 12 lakhs. So wherever location demands, I would say pay the rent. It's worth it. But however, don't get into a rush that, you know, at any location, I'm ready to pay double the rate, because that will only, you know, tighten the grip on you, on your operational cost month on month. I'm sorry, I forgot your first question.
That was about technology, because we see a lot of business now coming online through delivery platforms. How prepared is you know, your brand to cater to that platform?
We are completely listed on all online platforms that exist today, be it the smallest ones or the biggest ones. With some, we are exclusively tied up, like our two outlets in Mumbai are exclusive on Zomato. So there we've got a commission rebate. We get some extra support from them only to be on their platform and not the other platform. So these are, again, subjective decisions, but I've taken it, but I have a lot of help and support in being exclusive. So online is something which is the future. People are going to get hooked on to ordering food, because it's simple. You don't need to call the restaurant, explain your address, nothing. The GPS catches it. Food is delivered to you within a span of 25 to 30 minutes. So as simple as, you know, it's just that keep changing with the technology, keep adding and keep evolving. Because if I am a firm believer that if you are going to be very, very adamant that, you know, this is how it is and I'm only going to do this, I think that creates a little bit of, you know, animosity between today's time and how things were up to 6 months, 8 months back. So thing is that keep evolving is the only thing. Keep evolving this, you know, keep your core strong, but keep evolving is what I would say.
Sure. I think one question which I saw is, you talked about the shelf life of the product. There's another question on the shelf life of the gravy which is supplied, is one question. And the second is, I'll take it up together, is satellite kitchens. Are we looking at doing in the same location, which is Bombay, where you already have existing outlets? And if you're opening outside, is one of the questions which I have from one of the audience. How do we survive? So we need to have a centralized kitchen or a master before we open a satellite kitchen. So satellite kitchen, as we speak, is the opportunity only available for Bombay. Is that right?
So satellite kitchen is currently the opportunity available for Bombay, for Nasik and for Goa, where we currently have outlets. The second question is the shelf life of the gravy. The shelf life of the gravy is 3 months in a refrigerated form. It comfortably stays. And if you want to keep it in the freezer, it stays for more than a year. Because these are all vacuum-packed gravies, certified, ISO-certified processes that we have in place with a proper facade following that we do. So these gravies have shelf lives up to 3 months. And if in the freezer, it's more than a year.
And there is somebody who's asked a question that in some locations, or particularly for Muslims, I think halal food is very important. So if they want to start up a full halal kitchen, is it possible? Is your gravies get that certification? Because, you know, suppliers...
So all the meats are 100% halal that we serve at all our outlets.
So this is good. I think there is a huge opportunity for doing even complete halal food offering. And because I think it creates, at least for a lot of Muslim community, they would like to only go and order from there. So not many players are doing that. I think there is a huge opportunity for people to consider.
I'll take one question which is again on the location. I see many questions coming. Will the brand be able to help investors to pick the right location based on the surveys or the data perhaps you would have, which comes from the delivery companies, you know, which location, which demographics have the higher demand of biryani? So will that help or the data be provided to the franchisee, and will brand be helping these people to select locations where the demand is higher?
Definitely the brand would have a major say in the right location, because obviously as a brand, I wouldn't want you to shut, and I would want you to maximize the opportunity for yourself and for us. So the brand has a major say in the choosing the right location or the right spot, obviously in consultation with our partner, because he is a local over there. He would understand it even better than us. But again, it's a joint thing where the brand has a major say, because only from the online perspective, the radius. The data obviously is not shared because it's not yet authorized to be shared. But these are insights, as I may call it, these are insights that we get on the relations that we have. So based on those insights is how we advise our franchise partners on choosing the right location.
Sure. And what is the kind of radius which is given to a franchisee within which the other outlet would not come in, certain kilometers or it is based on locations, because certain locations would be dense, which would require maybe more outlets than the lesser densely populated areas?
No. So since we concentrate on a majority of our business being online, the radius offered to every restaurant is about 4.5 kilometers per se. So we usually keep a demarcation of 5 kilometers as a radius, as a round, that no outlet comes in, because what happens then is clashes happen and, you know, both the people lose on business. So we keep a demarcation of 5 kilometers between franchisees so that none of them have a clash with each other.
I see more or less we've tried and covered a lot of questions, and some of these are very specific to the city. People are asking very specifically if Odisha Master is available. They want to understand how the costing works, media platforms that you currently use to market the brand. I feel with these discussions we can have maybe one-on-one, because very specific to the individual and locations they are looking at.
You know, one question I would have, which is because preference on platforms or any other delivery structures, because you're not seeing the physical interface of the store, the entire credibility goes on the ratings, how you drive the ratings on them and things like that. So what kind of work you do on ratings and how you really push the quality up, because the reassurance is how much you are rated on Zomato. I know it's also paid and there are a lot of other things goes around that dam. You would like to educate everybody on how one should really survive in a difficult or so competitive environment?
So ratings play a major role, and Zomato reviews play an even major role in a person whether he wants to choose a biryani, because I think more than Googling a food brand today, people Zomato it. So yeah, it's always good to keep your page good, but again, fake reviews are such that fake reviews, a lot of people do it, but that will only help you survive temporarily. You know, a person would see your rating as 4.8, probably be excited, but the moment he tastes your food, you know, he would always be disappointed, because the bar or the, you know, the expectation has been set so high. So what we do is all our ratings are organic. And in fact, you know, as per Zomato's new process, which just began last week, ratings and reviews cannot be added by food bloggers or something. It can only be added if you have ordered food from the outlet. So it's becoming more organic by the day. And Swiggy has always been completely organic, that only if you have ordered from the outlet is when you can rate it. So I've kept it organic, you know, where it's good, where it's bad, but the bad just helps us improve by knowing that, you know, this outlet needs attention or there is something wrong happening, or in some certain item, there is something going wrong. So I always believe it's never good to, you know, put these planted reviews, because then the benchmark or the expectation is set so high that somebody would always have that, you know, in 89 rupees, you'll expect a biryani, which is from a 5-star. So I've always kept the benchmark completely organic and natural as it is.
Excellent. So what I should ask you some personal questions out of the whatever you do, you know, you are a product development side, you product or menu engineering, you're a marketeer, you don't also have to do operation. Which part of all that you like the most and you want to contribute most?
I think menu engineering is fun. because that is something which really tests whether you can capture the market. See, because taste is something which you're not cooking, the chef is cooking. You cannot really go and taste every biryani. So I think the menu engineering or the menu mix is something which is very critical and crucial in today's time. You have to have something which is Instagram friendly. You have to have something which is massy. You have to have something which is value for money. So I think that is something which is a challenge and that is fun.
Okay, now the second question is that out of, obviously your biryani is great and we've all tried it. And which other biryani company or brand or any chef you will have, you will say that my biryani would link to closer to this guy or whosoever needs to be done. Because we have a lot of, I mean, traditional brands in Hyderabad. There is a brand Paradise and there is a lot of, so people have their opinion. And I know biryani is also very differently cooked and different. Calcutta is very different. Chennai is very different. Hyderabad is different. Bangalore is different. Bombay is different. So what do you think? Is there anybody you like really where you have a desire to go and say, I go and only eat that biryani? And we'll not hold you for this.
So I think the best biryani where I only actually go is in Calcutta. There's a small place in Park Street which gives you biryani with egg, potato and the meat. And it's dry. I like the biryani dry because I'm bored of eating it with the masalas. But a lot of people like it with masala. But I like the dry biryani. So it's something which is fantastic. And then there's this place in Delhi where we call from Matka Peer, which is very famous, obviously, and very good. So that is one place which I think is my favorite.
Okay, excellent. That's a good feedback. And you're an honest guy. So you can always... Otherwise, I've seen a lot of people only appreciating their work. They don't appreciate other people's work. Good work. Last comments from you, Sonia, and you, Akshay. And what we will do is we will also take all the questions which people are asking for area franchise or a master franchise. And our team will reach out to them. We put our numbers and everything and start organizing your one-on-one calls with everybody. So, Sonia, your comments?
Okay, sure. Thank you so much, Akshay. I think that was very interesting to go through how you work. And I feel for the investors, the way real estate has been rationalized, a good mix of maybe the convenience food that you have in your menu and the value-added dining or delivery experience, smaller format, smaller capex, all that adds a lot of value for the investors to consider this as an option. And today, a lot of business sustainability will depend on how strong the operating model is or system is. And we feel you've been able to engineer that to an extent. And these 2-3 months have given you a lot of understanding of perhaps the market. And I, based on our last discussion, I feel the model is great to go and scalable across all the markets. So we wish you all the best. And we look forward to working with you in this year.
Great. Thank you so much and it's been a pleasure and insights are always good and it's always good keep talking to a lot of people always keep getting insights from the stalwarts of the industry like Mr. Maria and you and it's always been fun to be a part of discussions because it's always something that I take home so I always look forward to our next interactions.
Thank you
very much and I would also like to take home the person who runs biryani and eats biryani every day and still be very fit. What is the reason for that? So given a choice, I can have a biryani every day, but the only thing I get worried is that I put on a lot of weight. So how you get fit is maybe next time webinar on that.
Definitely.
Archana, over to you.
So thank you so much, Gaurav sir. Thank you so much, Sonia ma'am. Thank you so much, Akshay, for giving us that understanding about your brand. As Dheeraj mentioned in your chat tool, you can contact us. You can contact Franchise India team through your calls, through your emails, and you can also contact Gaurav sir and Sonia ma'am through their LinkedIn. So these are the various means where you can be in touch with Franchise India for all your queries. And we would love to help you with every kind of the queries. So that's the information about tomorrow's webinar. We are doing a special edition for this particular brand, which will be there live on 7th of June, sharp at 4:15. So you have to keep in mind, this particular webinar is scheduled for 4 to 5 p.m., where we have a speaker, Joby, who is the CEO of this laundry based India's largest manufacturer of commercial laundry equipment. He comes directly tomorrow to interact each one of you. So look forward to have you tomorrow for this great session. And take good care of yourself. Best wishes for the day.
Thank you.
Thank you.